batches. We don't need no stinking badges. We're restaurant reviewers.
We are. We're also sponsored, Party Down is sponsored by Malvin Wicket Car Inspection. Christmas deal, $200 if all you want is the sticker and no inspection. By the way, Brad, where did we go this?
Went to Alfonso's Mexican and Seafood Restaurant on South Fraser Street in Conroe, man.
Conroe. I've passed that place almost a billion times. I've never been there. It's been different things, I think.
It's been there for a long while, Mark.
Oh, it has.
It's been there for a long while.
You know what attracted me to it, Brad, was the sign that was sitting out there, the yellow sign that was so inviting.
That's in Spanish, and no one could. I can't read it. Well, I have no idea what
it was missing
doing.
Some letters.
But yeah, well, it was probably missing more than that. And so is the restaurant, by the way. When we walked in, they were missing patrons.
There
were a lot of people. It's never a good sign when you go to a restaurant at high noon and there's only, what, three people?
There were three people.
There were three people in there.
And when we left, 45 minutes later, there were five people. So it had grown. But, Brad, let me say this about it. The exterior isn't that inviting. It's next to the bingo hall and that kind of stuff. But when I went inside, I was very pleased with the interior. It looked festive and nice and clean.
I'm glad you were, because I wasn't impressed. Looks like kind of an after. It looks like we put up a restaurant, we're going to sit back and the people will come. Well, that ain't the way things work these days, folks. And if you're only going to have one waitress, I guess it's a good thing they only had three patrons when we got there.
That's true.
So, the atmosphere, Mark liked it. He didn't know what he's talking about. As usual, I had to have the fajitas.
This time,
they had an offer of get some shrimp with that for just $1.50 more.
Seafood restaurant.
How can you go wrong? So I had the beef fajitas and shrimp.
Since it was a seafood restaurant, Mexican seafood restaurant, I asked the lady, should I get seafood? And it was like,
She don't care, man.
I got the fried tilapia because the picture on the menu looked pretty good.
Yeah, those pictures will steer you wrong, buddy.
Brad, I don't even know what a tilapia is, but boy, they're all over the place now. It turned out, Brad, just very thin. I liked the crust on it, but it was tasteless. It came with rice. The menu said rice and beans. I got rice and fries. That's two starches, Brad.
Two starches.
Mom will kill you.
I got the fajitas, and I love fajitas, and I was underwhelmed by these. I think they might have been reheated from, last week, last month, something like that. There wasn't much done with the presentation. There weren't a lot of extras with it. The shrimp, they just sort of tossed them in, and they're the kind of shrimp you get at the grocery store, the frozen ones tasteless. It just wasn't a great meal. I was a little disappointed in the meal.
Brad, I don't remember it popping and everything and being real hot when it came out.
A little bit. Not a lot, but there was still a little bit of shimmer and glimmer to it when it came out.
I was probably just looking at my fish.
So anyway, I was a little disappointed in the meal. So at the end, I noticed that they had ice cream. I said, hey, bring me a scoop of ice cream.
And I said, none for me, because a scoop of ice cream, that's just going to get me started.
Well, there you go. But the waitress really came through on this one. I didn't get one scoop. I got two big scoops of ice cream covered with chocolate sauce with a maraschino cherry pleasantly placed on top.
Wow, maraschino or maraschino?
Well, what do you know?
No nuts also, and he doesn't like pecans and stuff like that.
No, I don't. I don't. So, I'm a little disappointed. I think for a restaurant that's been around for a while, they need to ramp up their act a little bit. Put a little more effort into the atmosphere, service, and the food.
Really, and you need to go there because they really need the business. I don't know. Their rent must be very low.
And you can go play bingo right after you eat.
It's unbelievable. It's a great...
Hey, I'm Brad Meyer, restaurant critic for Houston Community Newspapers.
Mark Cater, columnist for Courier and the Villager.
Until next time, bon appetit.
Bon appetiters. I know it was a little...